2019, but today I will take you exactly 200 years back in time. So 2 centuries ago, in the year 1819, Kudrat ne kuch aisa khel khela that changed the fate of a once flourishing port town. And that town is our today's destination, the town of Lakhpat. But more on what happened 200 years ago, later. Welcome to the second episode of the Kutch series, as the story of my Kutch continues.
Hope you have seen my previous video and have all the information you need to reach Pooch. So these are the things I'm carrying: water bottle, or rather bottles, jacket. Make sure you carry a jacket because it has been chilly since last week, and some snacks.
That's tape line there. Good job.
Oh, you're so funny.
Also, make sure you are wearing your comfortable shoes, and since we are going to a border area, it is advisable to carry a photo ID, and if you are not an Indian, then you will need to carry your passport and a permit, which is easily available from the DSP office in Bhuj on any working day. Well, our drive from Bhuj to Lakhpat will take us roughly 2.5 hours to cover a distance of 150 kilometers.
Theories that emerge as to why Lakhpat is called so. First being that it was named after the then erstwhile Maharao of Kutch, Rao Lakhpat ji, also known as Lakha ji. The other popular belief, and the one that I like more, is that the name Lakhpat came about because it brought in an income of 1 lakh kauris on a daily basis. So kauris was the currency of Kutch at that time, and it was made up of silver. So I remember my grandfather telling me that he has used kauris in his time, and trust me, if you have some kauris with you right now, you would be minting money. So Lakhpat is also the westernmost part of India, also known as the ghost town of Kutch. So what you see behind me is the first site of the Lakhpat fort. In this drive of 150 kilometers from Bhuj to Lakhpat fort, as soon as you cross Panadru, you will not find anyone on the way. So make sure you have your map sorted on the Google Maps. So this is the Gurudwara Nako, built from brown stones like most fort in Kutch are. It is a mixture of both Islamic and Hindu architecture. Most of its 20 feet high walls stretch across a circumference of 7 kilometers. 4 lofty darwajas and 24 watchtowers still stand strong, braving the wrath of nature, telling the stories of its glorious past. Again, let's get back in time. So with its dwindling prosperity and the threat of constantly being looted, Fateh Mohammad, the then administrator of Lakhpat, proposed to the king, Raja Raidan III, of building a gated wall around the fort. But Raja Raidan rejected the proposal, stating that the council did not have enough funds. So Fateh Mohammad made a plan of looting the neighboring town of Pir, reigned under the king Mozo Pir. Though Fateh Mohammad and Raja Raidan were successful in building the wall around the fort, Mozo Pir, who was on the Hajj Yatra while his town was looted, could not take the news and he died soon after. The construction of the gated wall got completed in 1801, but 18 years later, disaster struck and took it all from the rulers of Lakhpat. So what happened 200 years back in time that turned this town into a ghost town? Well, on the ill-fated evening of 16 June 1819, the death knell of the prosperity of Lakhpat was sounded. A massive earthquake, which was later named Allahabad earthquake, rumbled from the sea into the then lush rice fields of Lakhpat, cracking the spine of the prosperous town, killing more than 1,000 people in its wake and dooming the fate of many others. Experts are of the opinion that the changes caused due to the 1819 Allahabad earthquake were enough trigger to cause the 2001 Bhuj earthquake. So what happened that changed the fate of Lakhpat and turned it into a ghost town? So the earthquake of 1819 forced the once flowing Sindhu River to change its course and flow 50 kilometers west, thus condemning Lakhpat Bandar, and the fortified town turned into a ghost town.
So this is the outer wall, or the old fort built by Lakha ji, and the ruins of the extension built by Jamadar Fateh Mohammad can be seen over there.
A अभिषेक बच्चन की पहली पिक्चर याद है रेफ्यूजी? वेल, इट वॉज इंस्पायर्ड फ्रॉम द शॉर्ट स्टोरी लव अक्रॉस अ सॉल्ट डेजर्ट बाई केकी एंड दारूवाला, अ पद्मश्री. एंड वॉट बेटर प्लेस टू शूट इट देन अ सॉल्ट डेजर्ट इट सेल्फ. सो इफ यू हैव सीन द फिल्म रेफ्यूजी, यू मस्ट हैव सीन बिट्स एंड पीसेस ऑफ लखपत फोर्ट.
When Karachi, which is just a few kilometers on the other side of the border, had a population of 5,000, Lakhpat had 15,000 rich people living here. It was that prosperous, but today it is left with only 500 villagers in it. Also, like Punjab and Hyderabad, Lakhpat has a namesake in Pakistan. Right now, we are circumferencing the 7-kilometer periphery of the fort, which also houses the 9-domed Abu Tarab Dargah, a gurudwara where Guru Nanak Sahib himself stayed, the ruins of the Akhbani palatial home, a custom house, and the mazar of Pir Ghaus Mohammad, which is our first stop.
So we are at the mazar of Pir Ghaus Mohammad, a Sufi saint who was revered by both Hindus and Muslims. So don't confuse him with the Ghaus Mohammad of Gwalior. He is different. He lived much earlier in the 15th century. So the mazar is also known as Kubo in the local language, and it was built by the brother of Peer in 1855 after his death. So the Peer became a fakir at a very early age, and he was believed to have healing powers. So the pond over here is believed to have the healing powers. So you will see that Kubo is more intact as compared to other monuments because it was built after the earthquake that the other monuments were affected by.
So this Kubo is an excellent example of Indo-Islamic architecture. It has features influenced by many architectural styles such as Multani, Persian, Egyptian, Mughal and the Hindu influence too. The mausoleum is a three-tiered structure. Its first tier is this 54 square feet platform that is 7 feet high. The second tier is an octagon. The walls go inward and come out like a blooming flower. The third is the dome. And the octagonal walls and the dome are connected by the squinch band. On top of the dome, there is an amlaka similar to that found in the Hindu temples. The geometric patterns of interlacing foliage, tendrils, jali work, and even the tree of life are found in most Islamic buildings, the best of which is found in the king of all maqbaras, the Taj Mahal. Inside, there is main vault of Pir Sahib. Under this beautiful pink marble canopy that is carved with the jali work similar to that of the Mughal period.
So to spread the message of Almighty, Guru Nanak Sahib travelled across India and other countries, and his travels are known as Udasis. And he has done 5 Udasis during his lifetime. So it is believed that he stayed here and passed through Lakhpat
during his travel to Mecca, his 4th Udasi, along with his companion Bhai Mardana, and at that time Lakhpat was called Bastabandar. This Gurudwara was built by the first leader of the Udasi sect, Baba Chand Sahib, who was also the oldest son of Guru Nanak Ji. The Padukas that you see and this palki are piously worshipped here as they are believed to be the personal belongings of Guruji himself. Recently, the 550th anniversary of the birth of Guru Nanak Ji was celebrated just a few days after the historic opening of the Kartarpur corridor, which allows Indians access to one of Sikh's holiest shrines in Pakistan. Here they serve langar for the whole day, so this is a good option for you to have your food here. In 2004, UNESCO conferred its Asia Pacific Heritage Award to this Gurudwara for its cultural heritage conservation.
So the locals of Lakhpat state that Azim Premji, the philanthropic billionaire, and the shipping barons of Oman Bhatias have their roots in Lakhpat. And then there were the Akhbanis. So we are standing right in front of the ruins of the Akhbani palatial home.
About them, the locals say that they were so generous that people back then used to say, Ya to Allah jo asro, ya to Akhbani jo, which means either God or the Akhbani family helps during tough times. Delving into the relics of this house is like peering into the richness and generosity of this family.
This is the custom house, and this is one of the main administrative offices during the 19th century. and people would pay taxes over here to take their goods further inside Kutch. So finally we are at our last stop in the Lakhpat fort, that is the 9-domed masjid.
So Sayyid Pir Shah Abu Tarab lived in Lakhpat in the late 18th century. The locally quarried and intricately carved lime and stone dargah was built by his followers in his memory after that. So with this, we bid farewell to Lakhpat, the last bastion, with the prayer that before the year 2019 ends, the curse that began in 1819 also ends. Mere Kutch ki is hisse ki kahani kaisi lagi dosto? If you liked it, do let me know. So see you at our next destination when we take a holy journey through Narayansarovar and Koteshwar.